Hey class, it's Bill Berry with the supplemental video on formatted output. Several of our projects have had the need for having output looking nice and lining up, and we want to look at some options that we might not have explored before and look at how we can use them to line up our output in a better way. Let's start with our first example. When we first started learning about this, let's say we have some data here and some variables, and we want to line things up, and we want to have a column for name and phone and age and balance. Well, the first thing we understood was that we can have a print statement and we can put commas between things, and when we did that to do separation, it did some form of separation, yes, but it only put a space between things. So you can see that pretty much that was icky. Look down here and you see that really doesn't line things up very well. So we really don't like that a heck of a lot. So let's go and look at some other options that we can use instead. Well, second thing that we learned to do is we learned that tabs might help us a little bit. And so we can do tabs, but we found out that they were a little bit imprecise. Sometimes you got to put two tabs to make things move over, and then one tab over here is all that's necessary. And then here we've got to stick things on, and if it's a string, you can just concatenate it, but otherwise you got to take the age, turn it into a string, so you can concatenate. You know, really this is icky. And if one thing gets a little bigger, if the age ticks over to one more digit or something like that, sometimes that's enough to throw it off and then the next thing doesn't line up right. So we know that that's just kind of poor, right? We really shouldn't use tabs. In fact, we really should never use a tab. It's kind of a poor method. So let's look at another method, and this is closer to what we've learned, and that is you can format, use the format function, and you can tell it what you want to put there and how you want it to format it. And we were used to doing things like this, like customer age, we want to format it as a D, which is an integer, right, a digits. And so we can say format the customer age and take up a minimum of 5 spaces. And we also then know that if we take each of the headers and we treat them the same way, we can use S for the format specifier, right, with strings, and we line up the name and then the dashes, right, this is going to be 15 dashes. And notice that if all of these say 18, even if they're not all S's, but if they all say 18, like these say 5S and 5D, we know that they're going to align. And then we can just separate them with commas and we know everything's going to be great. Now notice there are a few little tricks here that I've used. One is if you want to right align a particular thing that is normally left aligned, like a string, you can put a greater than sign. And so greater than 5S says right align it within the 5. And you can also use less than, but that's the default. So, you know, you don't really need to use that too much. You could use that here as well, but for numbers, it's going to automatically align them at the right side because it knows that's how numbers ought to be. So this works pretty well, and you can see with the balance, we did the same thing, right? I did greater than 10s, and then I put some dashes, and then I used 10. So again, 10, 10, 10, everything is 10, so we know that's going to line up. So let's save that, and let's run it, and we'll see what we get out. And you'll notice everything lines up exactly as we expect it to. So that's great. So we know if we want to tweak them, we can just come and change all the 18s to 19 or 20 or something, and we just go down the row and change that one, that one, that one. So that works great. Now we could also pull these things out and make them constants, so we could change them at the top of the program without having to come down with the code, but certainly the code is aligned very nicely, so it makes it super easy to have that work. So that's as far as we know so far. That's a good way to do things, but it still feels kind of clunky. There's an awful lot of different columns and fields that we're putting in here, and it really doesn't feel quite natural yet. It seems like it's too much work. So let's learn one more method, and here's the basis of it. Have you ever heard of a Mad Lib? If not, you can look it up, but a Mad Lib, there were these little books that you would ask somebody some questions, and you'd say, give me a noun, give me a verb, give me an adjective, and they might give you a series of answers like this, ball, walk, purple, hurriedly, whatever. And so then what the book would do is have you fill in those blanks, and you'd put them in wherever in the little story that it showed you to put them in, and then you'd read out the answer, which would often be quirky or strange or sometimes hilarious. And so think of the format placeholders that we're going to learn about here as Mad Libs. You can put multiple of them in a format string and it will fill in the blank as appropriate. So in this case, this is how it's going to work. Let me start with the, we're going to construct a sentence, and then we're going to put a format specifier in here, blah, blah, blah. Let's put in our story. Say to the, and I'm going to replace these later, and then we're going to say, hey, blah, blah, blah. Let's see, in fact, I'm going to put the adjective and then the noun, and then I'm going to say, I'm going to put the verb, very, and then I'm going to put the adverb there, and then I'm going to say home, exclamation, blah, and then put a backslash n, right? So I'm going to make a string that's going to hold the fill in the blanks. Now, obviously, I'm not going to use underscores, but I just want to give you the idea. Now, the next part is you're going to say dot format. So rather than using the format function, we're using the format method on a string object. Now that's a little bit far from what we've talked about. We really haven't talked about a lot of objects and methods and stuff like that, but it's a function that is called off of a particular thing. In this case, it's a string. So from the string, we put a dot, and then we tell it what we want it to do. So we're saying, hey, string, we want you to be formatted the following way, and then I'm going to fill in the noun and the verb and the adjective and the adverb. Right. So the last thing that we're going to do is put in all of those things that we want to be filled into the blanks. And notice they have an order. There's the noun, and then the verb, and then the adjective, and then the adverb. Now, over here, how do we fill them in? Well, this becomes the zeroth item. This is the first item. This is then the second item, and the adverb is the third item. So we fill them in by using a placeholder that is numbered. So in this case, we want to address the noun, so I'm going to put these guys, and in the middle, I'm going to put a zero. That says fill in the zeroth placeholder here. In this case, I want to use the adjective, so I'm going to put in the second placeholder. I want to use the noun again, which is one of the purposes here. Notice I can use the zeroth item in any spot that I need, and I can use it again, which is very handy. And then I'm going to put the verb, so that is going to be number one. And then I'm going to put the adverb here, and that's going to be number three. So I'm saying fill in all of these spots where you see curly brace, zero, any of these positional items, fill it in with the appropriate position here. Into that, I will then construct the sentence, and then I will print the sentence. Of course, I could print the result of that directly. I don't have to make a separate variable for it here, but I'm doing that just for illustration purposes. Now let's run it, and let's see what we get out. So notice we have filled in our little Mad Lib exactly where we said. Here's the adjective, the noun. The noun was used here as well. And there's the verb, and there's the adverb. So it's filled in those blanks exactly as we have asked it to. So that's the basis for these things. Now, I want to show you one more item before we move into, reproducing all of this that way. One more idea here, and then I'm going to do this. I'm going to set up another variable, and I'm going to say, what if I wanted to say the customer's balance, the balance for, and I want to say, in this case, I'm going to put some stuff, and then I'm going to say dot format, and I'm going to pass in the customer balance and the customer name in whatever order I want, right? Doesn't matter. Customer name, cust balance. All right, so I'm going to now, I want to put the customer's name there, so I'm going to say this, and that is position 0, right? The zeroth item is the customer name, and then I'm going to say equals, and then I'm going to give it another thing, right? I'm going to say I put the balance right here, so number 1 gets filled in there. All right, so that's going to work, and I can say that the print line is going to here. And so that's fine, and it's going to work. Let's put this in the corner for you. Oops, cust bal not defined. I guess I better type correctly. It's called balance up here. Better be called balance here, right? Sorry. All right, so here we go. And there we go. So balance for John Q. Public is 1234.56. Well, that's great, but it's not really pretty yet. So the next thing to understand, first of all, anything you type in here that is not a placeholder is going to be treated literally. So in here, the quotes were literal, the commas were literal. Only the placeholders are being acted on by this format command as fill-ins. So that's important to know. Now, the next thing to know is, so you won't be surprised if I do this, right? I can put a dollar sign here. That's not a special format specifier. That just says put a dollar sign because it's not in the curly braces. But inside the curly braces, you can also move forward with special kinds of formatting. And if you want to do that, you put a colon here, and then you put that formatting. So in this case, I can say something like, 0 or, 0.2f. Or in this case, comma 0.2f, or 8 comma 0.2f. These are the same specifiers that we used up here, right? In this case, we put 10.2f for a floating point number. In here, I put 8 comma 0.2f for a floating point number. That's the same specifiers. The thing is, it comes after a colon, and that comes after the number of the fill-in. So take the first fill-in, and here is the formatting for it, 8, 0.2f. Now in this case, I want the dollar sign to be right next to the number, so I'm not going to do this. Now if I needed to align them, I would still want to do that, right? But let's just use this as an example for the moment. So understand, stop and pause and watch that and see if you understand how that works. And then let's run it and we'll see how the output looks. Sure enough, I got exactly what I wanted. I got the dollar sign right there. I got the comma notation. I got the dot, and I got two decimals exactly as I wanted it to be. And that was all done from this. Now, once you understand that, now let's look at the, perhaps most zen of all of these options. And I'm going to put it up here because it's kind of parallel to what we've been talking about up here. So, using that same stuff, if I want to put the customer name, phone, age, and balance into a nice output formatted line, I can simply say, take the zeroth item and align it in 18 spaces, right, 18 string. So it's going to be a string 18 long, left aligned. Then take number 1, that's the phone, and make it at least 14 in width. That's going to be left aligned because that's the default for a string. Then put a space, right? You don't have to have these spaces if you don't want them, or you can put more. Then take number 2, which is the age, and that's going to be a 5D. That's an integer, but the headers and the little hyphens are going to be right aligned, not left aligned. Then I'm going to put the balance, that's the third item, and that's going to be right aligned for the headers and right aligned for the hyphens, but on the balance itself, I want you to use 10.2f. Again, because these are all tens, we know they're going to align, and we've put exactly one space in between. Don't do this, right? It's one space in between. Or no spaces, right? As long as you've left enough room for your items, you don't necessarily need any spaces at all. So now we have something where we can put a whole bunch of things, and then we can list what we want to have out, and it's a lot shorter than this silliness, right? It gets a lot less tedious, and we sort of say this is our whole formatting line. We could put this as a constant and go tweak that, right? Bring that out and put it at the top, and we have a nice constant. Then you can tweak those things very nicely if you want, but we know that this output's going to align by nature. So now let's show that output again and go to the bottom, and sure enough, all of these things align very nicely as we knew they would, right aligned, and we could put the commas in here very easily as well, right? So we know now exactly how we do that. We would just go down here and go boop, there we go. So this is using a different kind of formatting than we have used before, but it's very convenient when you're doing reports. It's the thing that you want to concentrate on when you're trying to align a bunch of columns of stuff, and it works very nicely using the methods that we've shown here below. So watch that back, look at those placeholders carefully, but I think you'll see it's not really too hard, and it's just an extension of the little formatting of specifier knowledge that you've had from the past from using the format function. So hopefully that's helpful in upcoming work, and thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions via forums or email. Thanks for watching.